What's up, y'all? Welcome back to another episode of Next Gen Podcast, man. It's your boy, Destiny, a.k.a. Grateful Kid, man. And today, I have a special guest today, man. Can you introduce yourself, my brother?
I'm Cadet Cook. I currently go to PVMU. And I major in kinesiology.
That's what's up, man. Appreciate you for coming through for a one time, man. Sure. How's your day going?
It's chilling. I really just started. I woke up at like 2 to 2.
Oh.
Yeah, just got dressed to come here.
Just got woke up, man. Yeah. I'm glad that you came through for a one time, man. For those who don't know, man, can you introduce yourself, man? You know, tell them a little bit about yourself.
Yes, sir. I currently play rugby at Prairie View.
Oh,
so, yeah. And I'm also in the Army. And I'm in the ROTC program.
Okay. That's what's up. So, how did you find out about ROTC, Prairie View, and all that, man?
You know, my uncle, he's a retiree. He was in the Army, and so was my brother. My brother in the Army currently.
Oh, for real?
Yes, sir. He in the National Guard. He literally just left last night to go back to his duty station.
Okay.
Yeah, and I don't know. It just gave me a sense of purpose. You know, I feel like Army ain't made for everybody.
So,
I don't know. I just felt like it was my time to go.
Well, how'd you know it was your, you know, you wanted to actually do it as opposed to just like, you know, maybe it's not like you just wanted to try out, but like, you know.
Yeah, but before I joined, it's like I don't know what I want to do yet. So it's like I feel like Army will give me a purpose or give me a reason or a purpose in life to help me figure out what I got to do in life.
And okay, so when So could you tell us like the process behind you joining the Army and all that? How did you, like, who got you, you know, who was your instructor and all that?
So basically I had a recruiter.
Yeah.
You know, a Sergeant Givens. Shout out. Yeah, so I had talked to her cuz she's a National Guard recruiter. Right. So we talked out and then she sent me to basic training over the summer, which I went to basic training, but then I missed like 2 weeks of college, so
yeah,
it sucked, but it is what it is. So, bam, she sent me out to I went to Missouri, and then we went to this processing center where they got all your paperwork done and stuff, which took forever. And I felt like it was really a week, but it felt like 2 months.
Oh, for real?
Yeah, that shit sucked. But and after that, they send you off to your unit or your where you're gonna be staying for like most of the time, which basic training was like 2.5 months for me. So yeah, it was a cool experience though, because we did a lot of stuff. You know, we shot weapons, we threw grenades.
Oh, for real?
Yeah. I mean, hey, they give you free housing, food, and clothes, so yo, that was a plus.
So you know, I you know, watched some videos of, you know, the military and how y'all, you know, how they give y'all foods and all that. But like, is the food really good like that? Like,
hell no. Well, I'll tell you that. I mean, it was edible, I'll tell you that, but good? Nah, that's a stretch right there.
That's a stretch.
Hell no. It was alright though.
Okay. But why are you in the military? What's your, like, you know, or your rank and position, and what do you do?
So when I joined, I was enlisted. So there's a enlisted side and then there's an officer side. I joined as an enlisted, which I'm a private.
Yeah.
I was a private E2. So after I joined and then I was done with basic training, once I joined the ROTC program, my enlisted rate go away. So I'm now a cadet.
Oh, for real?
Yeah, and then once I graduate college and
you become a captain.
No, I become a second lieutenant.
Second lieutenant, oh, okay.
And then you rank up to a first lieutenant and then a captain.
Oh, then a okay.
Yeah, captain's up there.
Yeah, indeed. Okay. Since you've been in the military, man, what are some things that the military has given you? What are some opportunities that the military has given you personally?
Military is big. See, military is Army, Navy, Air Force, all that.
Well, so, okay, in your branch.
So,
where is it?
Yeah. It gives you a whole bunch of connections, though. It gets you connected with a whole bunch of people all around the world. I got battle buddies that's in North Carolina and New York, and we all experience different things, and we talk about it and, you know, help each other with certain things that we can't do ourselves.
Okay.
So it's like, it's the connection part that really gives you a boost.
When you started off in the going to you know, basic camp and all that, did you feel any pressure or like feel any, you know, maybe discouraged or any racism, you know, because of, you know?
Yeah, military is big on that. They got programs like SHARP and EO.
Yeah.
SHARP is like to prevent sexual harassment and all that, and EO is like to prevent, you know, racism and all that. So I mean, I didn't experience none of that, but they're really big on that. So.
Yeah.
That's what I like about it.
Okay, so you never experienced it, right? Even now, also, okay, that's good. That's
I mean, they'll be hard on you, but yeah, it ain't with all that racism.
Yeah, it's not. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, okay. What are some skills that you learned that the military has that the military is giving that you learned that you didn't know?
Oh, they taught me a lot of stuff. They taught me discipline. They taught me etiquette,
right?
Military etiquette, and it gave me experience. So I feel like that's the big part. I've done stuff that I ain't never thought I would do.
And what are some things that you never thought you could do that the military has given you, if you don't mind me asking?
So it's we went to this chamber thing, like they call it a gas chamber.
Okay.
Where they
I know what you're talking about. It's a test, right?
Yeah.
I know what you're talking about. Bro.
I never thought I was gonna go through that, but hell no, that shit burned like
it
a
really
mug.
Does burn. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Okay.
But I'm telling you, if you got sweat on you, that mug gonna start burning. And then once I got out there, I think you stay in there for like a minute. You go in with a gas mask.
Yeah.
So you breathe in the gas mask, and then you take it off, and then you breathe in that that gas, right, that burning gas, and then they let you out. And when I got out, I was trying to burp. I swear, I could not burp, bro. Some people threw up. Some people spit. Some people was crying.
I know about the crying. That shit was painful.
Yeah, that shit would, but. Yeah, yeah.
Damn, okay, okay.
Yeah, that was a cool experience, though. I never thought I was going to go through that.
Okay, so they didn't warn you. It was just like, we're doing this today.
Yep. It's part of it. It's part of the training.
Okay, okay.
Yeah,
okay.
It was cool, though.
Okay, that's what's up. That's what's up. What else? What else, you know, what was something that you didn't expect, but it turned out to be actually pretty cool?
So, I mean, it wasn't pretty cool, but it's like, so
yeah, it was like an experience.
We went to the gun range,
right?
Which, dang, that took the whole day. But I said shooting them ARs, bro. It's fun though. It's fun. I gladly shoot another one.
You said I'm glad to shoot another one.
I'm always fun. It's an experience I never thought I was gonna go through, but yeah, that was a cool experience.
Okay, okay. And what are some places, what countries have you traveled, if any, have you, you know, been there?
I haven't yet, but I plan on, because right now I got to finish college first.
Okay,
so
okay.
After I graduate, they'll station me somewhere, and then I'll be able to travel out the country and all that.
Okay, and you've already been contracted, right? You know, you're already contracted and all that, right?
Yes, sir.
So, that's a four-year contract too, by the way, right?
Yes, sir.
Four-year program.
So
okay.
You got to go into ROTC 4 years, and then get to graduate and become an officer.
Okay, okay. Why did you choose the Army as opposed to like the Navy, the Air Force? You know, why did that one stick? Why did that one stick out to you?
So I don't stick out to me because my brother's in it. So yeah. I mean, I really don't know much about all the other branches. I mean, I really didn't know much about the Army before joining.
Yeah.
But you know, my brother was in there, so I was like, I feel like that's the best way to go. Go behind his footsteps.
Oh, okay, okay. And when you know, decided to join the Army, who was the first person you told?
I think I told my mama.
For real? I thought you were gonna tell your brother. Don't lie.
Nah, my brother like the second person. I had to let my mama know though.
Okay,
I mean,
yeah, for sure.
she was a big reason why I joined the Army though.
Really? Like, can you?
It's like, I know she's proud of me, but sometimes I just feel like I don't got that sense of feeling. I feel like I do shit to make her proud. That's my main goal before she go away.
Right.
Make sure she happy.
Yeah. So when you told her, what was her first reaction? What was her reaction, if you can remember?
And she was like, she's proud of me. You know, everybody got a different story. Everybody got a different path. So shit, this might be my path. So
right.
As long as I'm happy, she's happy.
Okay, and then your brother, when
my brother's hype, bro.
He was like, my boy.
Yeah. Nah, he was ready. He's ready. What's his name? Because right now he's a higher rank than me, so he's like trying to be my boss and stuff. But yeah, we be joking around and stuff though. It's cool.
Oh, okay, yeah, okay. That's what's up, man. I'm glad that you know that you got the support that you need. And
yes, sir.
With that being said, man, what made you come to PV, man? How did you even find out about PV, man?
So, first of all, I love black people. No, my mama black, so.
Oh, really?
Yeah, my mama
black. Okay, I didn't want, hey, look, yeah. Bro, you know what I'm saying? I didn't want to jump into conclusion,
yeah,
bro.
Yeah, yeah, people don't know that, but I was adopted, so.
Oh.
Yeah.
That's what's up. Yes, that's what's up, man.
Yeah, so I had a friend that was going to come here. I was like, oh, wow, this seems like a cool school, you know, right. HBCU, all that. And so, bam, I applied. I got accepted. At first, I was an engineering major, electrical engineer. But
oh, for real?
Yeah, but okay. I changed my major to kinesiology because I felt like I wanted to be a PE coach. Not PE coach, but a teacher slash coach. Yeah. Oh, so, okay. Yeah, I want to coach, like, rugby and football and wrestling. I did wrestling back in high school. So.
Okay, so you're an athlete now.
Yes,
okay.
Sir. And I play rugby right now, so sure. Okay. Yeah, we trying to get work done around here.
Okay, that's what's so. Hey, man, you from my accent, so you know your mom's being black, and you know, your dad is.
I don't have a dad.
Oh, no. But has that impacted you in any way, or you never really looked at it like that? It's never really bothered to a certain degree.
You know, I used to have a father figure back then, yeah. But then he was my pastor, my youth pastor, but then he moved away with his wife. To start a family and stuff, which I was happy for him.
Right.
At that point, I ain't never look up to a guy again. So it's like I just have my mama.
Okay.
She was my father and
mom. Yeah.
Yeah.
With that being said, you know, did you ever feel, you know, left out, that you were missing anything, or it's never really, you know, because I know I talked to other people that have, you know, that never really had a father figure, but they said, like, you know, some said that it did bother them, some said that they didn't really notice it at all. So with you, did you really notice?
I feel like it ain't no one was left out. I feel like my mom did a good job of teaching me how to be a gentleman and also how to provide and stuff for myself and others. So okay. I feel like I really had nothing missing.
Okay, you know, you said being a doctor, right? Could you tell us, like, how did that, you know, make you feel, your first experience, your first feeling, like, oh, someone wanted me to be part of their family? How did you find out too? Like,
man, I feel like that was the best day of my life because, man, we went to court and we went to a judge court and she, you know, she just granted us adoption to our mama. I was like, I feel like it was the best day of life, and then we went to go out to eat after that. So, because I've been with her for most of my life,
right.
I think since I was like in fifth grade, and then I was in foster care, and then I think she adopted me around like middle school time. So yeah, I feel like that was like one of the best experiences.
Right.
I feel like because foster care is cool. Like, I mean, it's not good. I mean, it's all good and bad.
Yeah, it depends on, you know, of course, depends on what foster care and all that. That's actually one of the few questions I was going to ask you next. Like, you know, what are some facts and myths about being in a foster home? Because, you know, I see, you know, videos, I hear stories and all that, but then, you know, you being one, could you tell us, like, you know, what it meant to be a foster kid and, like, what it, you know, how it impacted you and all that?
Yeah,
and what's some facts and myths that people get wrong?
So, yeah, I mean, everybody ain't made to be a parent, though. So, it's like, foster care is, like, a good thing in the world, you know. But sometimes people use it as a money scheme where, oh, I'm going to have this kid, so I can have this amount of money. But, like, I mean, that's not with my experience, though.
Yeah.
I feel like I had a good experience. You know, I experienced a whole bunch of stuff I would have never thought I did. Like, for example, I went on a cruise, like, 2 years ago, which was fun. And I did a whole bunch of stuff. You know, celebrate birthdays, New Year's, Christmas, and all that. That was a cool experience.
But then when you finally, you know what I'm saying, got the paper saying, you know, they, you know, your mom's, you know, they found your mom. And that, you know, obviously, I'm pretty sure you felt pretty happy, you know what I'm saying?
I mean, so now that I'm adopted, I don't really worry about my biological parents.
Yeah.
Because I don't think I want to see them.
Yeah.
But it is what it is, though. Yeah. Yeah, I came out of them, but my real mama is... My mom, I got right now.
Yeah, sometimes, you know, family is not, it's not always by blood, you know. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so I definitely understand. But man, I'm very proud of you, man. You know, join the army, you know, join the RTC, do something for yourself as opposed to, you know, maybe not do something that's more impactful. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. You know, you just said that. What's it called? That actually, your mom's was actually one of the few reasons why you wanted to join the military. Is that right? Right.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Was she also in the service as well?
Oh, no, sir. But her She's a widow now, so her husband used to be in the military.
Oh, okay.
So yeah, I knew about that, but when I got to her, she didn't have a husband.
Oh, okay, okay. But going back to the military and all that, what was your realization? Was like, okay, that I'm actually part of the army, the United States Army. Like, what's your realization? Like, you know how people say like, you know, NBA players have like a welcome to the NBA moment. Like, what was your welcome to the army moment?
So we was on this bus. We had to carry this big bag full of our stuff.
Are you talking about like when you have no fresh out? It's about in Kentucky, like, you know, Fort Knox, Kentucky. Or are you talking about something else?
I think I'm talking about something else.
Okay.
So I had two realizations for real.
Okay.
So one was when it was in the beginning when we had got our stuff and stuff, and we had to get off the bus and put our stuff down. We went straight into workout.
Straight to workout.
Front leaning wrist, the push up position.
Oh, really?
So, bam! It was burning. It was like during the summertime, so the floor was hot and all that. Man, I was sweating bullets.
Come with me.
So I was like, damn. And then I hear all the drill sergeants yelling at everybody and stuff. I'm like, oh no, this real now. It's getting real around here. And then my second realization was graduation. When I graduated, Bessie training camp. I felt so relieved that it was over.
Yeah.
But I felt so proud that I made it through. Because at some moments, I felt like, damn, why did I even join? But I'm telling you, it's all worth it when graduation comes by, though.
I'm like, damn. I'm showing the fact that, like, damn, on the spot, once you came out the buzz, we just said, push us already, bro. Your drill instructor, could you elaborate on who was it? He, she, or, you know, was it male or female? Or. Your drill instructor.
Oh, my drill sergeant. Yeah. My drill sergeant was a dude. There was a senior drill sergeant, and then there was two other drill sergeants that worked with him.
Okay.
My drill sergeant was cool, but my senior drill sergeant, oh man, that guy's.
Oh, so you had two different.
Yeah, we had three people.
Oh,
one was a senior drill sergeant, and then two was regular drill sergeants. And my senior drill sergeant, man, that guy was mean. He was tough, but I feel like I like the way he, like, you know,
the way things. So, you know, if you watch some, you know, videos, I watched some videos about drill instructors, like, you know, they'll yell and all that.
Yep.
Did that really happen?
Of course.
Yeah. Okay, I just want to make sure. You know,
everybody yelled.
Because, like, you know, sometimes social media, you know, or, you know, YouTube, you know, gives you false info. So,
that was a real thing. They yell. They get all up in your face, bud.
For real?
Yeah.
Like, very close to you. Ooh, wow.
Mm-hmm. Ain't no joke. Hey, they get up all on you.
What made you now? Or did you ever feel like, man, if he comes to me close one more time, I'm going to knock his...
Oh, no. Hell no. Because I know they will whoop my ass. They... hey, no matter the size, no matter how they look, I'm telling you, they got some skills, man. They will beat you down.
They actually have... Drill instructors actually have skills? I ain't going to hold you because, like, drill instructors I represent, some of them look like, bro, I could kick their ass.
Yeah, I be thinking the same thing. But hey, I don't know about the fat ones, but like the because my drill sergeant, he was buff, like buff and muscular. Like that one punch, yeah, your ass out of there.
You talk about like Dwayne the Rock Johnson.
Nah, he was built like him, bro.
Oh, nah.
I'm like, damn. And his calves, bro. Oh, man.
Oh, okay,
like,
yeah. I can understand that.
That guy ain't meant to be messed with.
And he was, what's he black?
Yeah.
Okay. You don't have to tell me no more. I know.
But it was cool, though, because towards the end, we all, you know, I mean, we still keep that boundary of professionalism.
Yeah.
But towards the end, you know, we all got along with each other and started joking around and stuff because basic training is about to be over. So
yeah,
it was cool towards the end.
Having your three drill instructors, what did each one of them teach you and teach the team that you were on?
So my senior drill sergeant, he really taught us discipline because we really couldn't do none of the fun stuff. Cause there was three of us. There was a first, second, and third platoon.
Right.
And we was in the first. And our senior drill sergeant, while the second and third was to call our cadences and stuff, he wouldn't let us call our cadence until we get our step, our marching, and all that correct. So it's like, I feel like he taught us discipline. And another drill sergeant Owens, he taught us a lot of knowledge about the army, though, about like weapons,
right?
Assembly, disassembly, formation, walking, and all that jazz. So yeah, he was cool. And then there's one more, Joe Sajudice. I feel like he was just there. He was a funny guy. He be making jokes, and then we all be laughing. And then when we laugh, we get punished for it. So it's like,
damn,
yeah. Man, I'm saying,
you not capping?
I'm nailed no, cause when we be sitting in the meeting and he be in the background doing some dumb shit, bro, and then we all laugh. Yeah, everybody get up, front lean rest, push up.
Damn, on the spot. That's tough. Just for a joke. Man, they are. That's tough.
They ain't with all that now.
Oh, that's how it's tough. But yeah. Go on.
Nah, it was cool though. So yeah, I mean, I feel like my squad was cool. I've messed with my squad.
Yeah.
They all were different, and they all taught us different things. So,
and did you compete with other squads that were there in that camp? Mm-hmm. Okay,
yeah.
Okay.
So it was three platoons. So we all competed in, competed in like competitions like it's like Land Nav. We Ooh. Competed in that, and then
I know what you're talking about.
Yeah, and then we competed in this PT thing. So,
oh man, which one did you do? Did you do the 2 mile run?
No, we all did it, and then whoever has the best combined score,
yeah,
gets like a ribbon thing on their flag. Oh, thing.
They ain't say nothing about like if you win, you don't have to work out.
Hell no. if you run like Usain Bolt, you still working out. They don't care.
Damn. Okay. Yeah. Okay. See, that's why I'm glad they come here, so you could tell me the facts as opposed to the myths, bro. So I'm thinking like, damn. Yeah. If you beat, you know what I'm saying, if you you're the best one in your squad, man, you get some perks.
Hell no. Ain't no perks around here.
Oh, okay.
We all privates in their eyes. So,
yeah.
So yeah, I mean it's cool though.
Okay. That's what's up. No, of course, you know, each instructor taught you about, you know, what it means to be in the, you know, about the military, but did they also teach you about outside the military though?
So the skills we acquire in the military, we can use some of those in the real world. Like for instance, it's like everybody had different jobs.
Right.
Most of them was like 88 Mikes, which are truck drivers. So damn, you drive trucks in the military. And once you retire, you can still drive trucks outside and make your bread that way. And then it's also like, I mean, they sometimes teach you like people skills and stuff, like help you talk with others. So it's like,
what are some skills that you thought like, man, I have this, I got this, I'm him.
So,
but then you know you actually do it, and you're like, oh wait, hold on, I ain't him.
So I mean, I thought I was pretty fast, but man. When you see people all around the world, yeah, it puts a whole different perspective on life. Cause
yeah,
you think you're the best at one thing, but really, somebody out there is better than you. So.
And when you realize that, did that create a switch in your mindset where like, okay, now it's actually from time for me to actually put in the work.
Yeah. So it made me want to go harder. It made me want to do better. Especially with my PT score.
Right.
Cause the best score you could get is a 600. Mm. And then I got like a 540. And then somebody else had like a 580. So like, that's my goal, to you know, to get up there, to be better than him. But yeah.
And you know, It takes a lot. It takes, not everybody can do what you're doing in being the military, especially doing a PT, you know, even though it seems like the easiest one, you know, saying wake up at 5 a.m. Because, you know, I did that, I know that, you know, wake up at 5 a.m., 4 a.m., you know, so we just do a few laps and all that. But then when you start to, when you actually have to do repeating over and over and over, some people are like, man, you know, I'm not sure if I really want to continue or not. So what made you want to continue even when, you know, you're like, damn, this is actually, you know, what kept you from continue.
So first of all, I'm gonna say this: military ain't made for everybody.
Right.
Everybody ain't made for the military.
Right.
So you just gotta have that mindset to join.
So what was your reason for continuing? I supposed to like, man, let me just quit, bro. I don't want to do this no more.
So my main reason was, I could go to jail if I stop.
Okay. Yeah, that's okay.
Cause there's this thing called AWOL, which if you don't show up and all that, yeah, they'll track you down and send you to jail for treason and all that.
Oh, okay, yeah, that sounds that sounds like a good reason.
So yeah, ain't nobody trying to go to jail, so we all gotta finish this.
Oh yeah. Okay, that's understandable. That's understandable. you know, I was talking to some people that were, you know, in the military, like before they joined, they had like some role models that they looked up to or aspired to be. So who were your role models and people that you even from now or back then that you look up to?
So right now, I feel like I just look up to my brother at this point right now, because he's also experienced the same thing I'm experiencing. And I also look up to my mama. So those are really the two people I look up to that I hope I could be better in life.
Okay. Besides your family, is there anybody outside the family that you look up to that you train you aspire to be?
I don't know.
Not yet.
Not at the moment in life.
Okay. And you know, the reason I asked is because, you know, one of my role models is Eric Thomas. He's a motivational speaker, but he's not just a motivational speaker. He has a platform where he can reach a certain level of people, regardless if you're, you know, old or young. And you know, he's impacting a lot of people, especially the young generation. And that's what I'm trying to do.
Okay.
You know what I'm
saying? What's up.
Yeah. So that's why I asked. I don't know. Yeah. You know.
At the moment, I don't have one yet.
Yeah.
But we'll see you down the road though.
That's facts. That's facts. What's been your best experience here at PVMU?
So this is my second year.
Oh, this is your second? Oh, okay.
So it probably would be the first year. You know, it was a new experience, and I got to meet a whole bunch of people. So it was that was cool. I'm not really a party guy, nor do I drink. So
oh, okay. Yeah, I mean that's cool. Yeah. You know, me too, man. I'm only there if I'm getting paid. No lie.
Yeah, it'd be like that.
Best believe I will be there.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, would it be fair to say that, you know, in your time here, you're at this university, that you found a group of people that you can relate to?
Of course. Yes, sir. I actually got one homeboy. I feel like we really close.
Is it Gentry?
No, it's a different dude.
Oh, guys, I'm gonna
mention Gentry be on some wild shit, bro. He be on some hardcore stuff.
That's to my boy, Diego.
No, yeah. I still fuck with him.
Yeah, me too, man.
We on boys.
Yeah, he my boy, man. He just mad funny.
Yeah, he is.
But okay, that's good. That's good. Because what's it called? You know, for me, you know, when I came here, I you know, I was a transfer student, so you know, I was like the new kid in high school. I didn't really know nobody, so I didn't know who had the same goal as me, or you know, who had the same ambition. It wasn't over time. I shout out to friends. Okay, you know, I'm blogging. There's a group of people where I belong. Yeah, mm-hmm. Shout out to my boy Tristan, man. The lemonade man. I don't know if you know who him, but yeah. Okay, so that's why. So you found a group of people where you
yes, sir.
You had some ambition.
Yeah, we all cool. We hang out.
And are y'all in the military, or some are in the military, some are not in the military?
Some are in the military and some aren't.
Okay. And have they taught you a little bit more about yourself as well?
I feel like what really teach me is like experiences. Those teach me the most. People that are in the experience, they taught me who I am and who I can be.
Okay. That's what's up. While you're here, are you also part of any organization, or have you thought about being part of any organization? Besides, you know, because I know you got the ROTC thing. That's that's organization as well. But have you thought about, you know, besides that?
No, because I feel like I have a whole bunch of on my plate right now. Right. So I got rugby, I got the army, I got school, and right. I got work. So it's like,
oh, you work?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
I work at Walmart.
Okay. That's understandable. Do you consider yourself or feel like you're stepping into a leadership position of as you've been in the military and outside the military?
So I feel like my whole life, in the beginning, I feel like I was a follower, but my mama always taught me to be a leader and stuff.
Right.
So I feel like in most positions, I do things well, how I want to do it,
right,
and how it could impact others and stuff. So yeah, the army, yeah, they're making me more of a better leader, more trustworthy. So it's like, because after I graduate, I'm already become a leader, because it's a whole bunch of other soldiers I have to take care of. So right. I think of their health and their mental health.
And that's a bit. But besides the military, do you being a leader in the military? Do you see yourself being a leader after, you know, in the civilian world?
Of course. I see myself being a leader because I eventually want to be a teacher. So,
I guess so. You want to be a teacher, and would you feel if you don't mind asking, do you feel like your influence will be more impactful in high school or in middle school or?
I feel like it'll be more impactful in high school because I'm really a competitive dude. So it's like if I'm a teacher, I'm also be a coach. So I want my players to be the best they can be. And at high school, I feel like they got the mental capacity to see what I'm talking about and to learn.
Okay, so okay, high school. So with that being said, then what would you try to install in your players?
So I feel like hard work.
No, besides the sport obviously, but besides all that, what are some key important things that you would want them to know? But not just for this about you, but themselves. You know
what I'm saying? I feel like the way you talk to others, treat others. Of course, it's so vague saying respect. I'm talking about you could be respectful, but then be on some dumb stuff. But like, I'm talking about how like you don't know what they're going through in their life, right. So it's like why I talk to them a certain way. So I feel like respect is a big thing for me.
Okay, so respect and discipline.
Yes, sir.
Inside your players. So with that being said, have you thought about like, man, you know, let's say you're coaching the team, right? Mm-hmm. And one of your players, right, is being hard headed. You know what I'm saying? Because he's been used to a certain lifestyle where like he's never been treated this way, or like, you know, he's seen things differently. Have you thought about that?
So of course,
how would you, you know?
So my brother, he's hard headed. So I know how they act. But it's like, I don't know, it just gotta be a consistent thing. You gotta like consistently do this certain thing to get it through their head to like, hey man, this is how we do things around here and all that. So yeah.
So would you say that the most important thing between a player and coach is the bond and the relationship?
I feel like
or
it is.
It's really the respect, discipline, then the bond, or how would you?
I feel like the bond could be a big part of it because if you coach a player and then they don't like you, it's not like they're going to give 100% for your team. Yeah. So I feel like, of course, there's that professionalism between teacher and coach. Teacher and student and coach and player. But it's like, we can still joke around and not do all that, but it's like we still got that professionalism right there.
Okay, indeed. What makes you want to become a coach? Supposed to, maybe you want to be a counselor, something else. Like, why coaching? Because that's a big thing. Because not only are you coaching, not only you represent the school, but you also represent yourself, mm-hmm. and the player's family. You know what I'm saying? That's a big responsibility. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
I picked coach because I actually recently went back to my little brother's school. And then I went to one of his wrestling practices. Man, I used to miss that because I love being in that kind of environment, a competitive and friendly environment. Yeah, it's going to get heated sometimes. That's how it is. But I feel like, I don't know, it's just my thing. I always liked coaching. I always liked, you know, being charged and telling people what to do.
Do you remember your coach Expedia. From what's it called? You know, the time you were in high school.
Oh yeah, I still keep in contact with him.
Oh, for real,
my wrestling coach.
Oh really? So yeah. Does he know that you're actually in the military and all that?
Because I want to be an assistant teacher.
Oh,
so I want to go back to that school and be a.
So you want to go back to the school that you graduated from?
Yes, sir.
Oh, really?
Yeah, and then he give me some recommendation letters and all that. So it's like I already got it hooked up now.
Really?
I just gotta take some classes and stuff.
Why would you want to go back? I supposed to go into any other? You know what I'm saying?
I feel like I'm already used to that school. There's people there that already knows me and all that. So it's like.
Oh, okay, that makes sense. I didn't know that. Okay, yeah. That's good though. That's going back to where you all started from.
Mm-hmm. And then you get some recommendation letter from your old school because they already know who you are and they already know how you act and all that.
I did not think about that like that. Yeah. Oh, you see that's one of the few things why I created this podcast to have moments like this. Like, oh,
yeah, it's cool though.
Okay, that's a bit. But going back to you being in the army, What has been like the your coolest moment or like the I can't talk about your missions and all that, but what's one mission that you know that you can't talk about that you know that's like, oh wow, this is actually legit? Like,
I feel like at the moment it's none right now.
Okay. So. But every time when you wear that uniform, how does it feel?
I feel like you carry a whole bunch of pride with it, because it's like it's history behind that uniform.
Yeah.
So it's like you do anything stupid behind it, yeah, you in big trouble. Mm-hmm. So it's like you gotta know what's right in army etiquette and all that.
And do you ever feel like that? Maybe that's like, you know, when you put on like, man, I'm not sure if I really deserve to wear this. Has that ever crossed your mind, or just like maybe just once that you know?
Sometimes when I don't have the energy, sometimes when I'm like, oh, I'm tired and all that,
yeah.
I feel like I can't represent this uniform like how I would want to.
Wow.
So it sometimes happens, but it's not like a constant thing.
Okay. That's not good. I just want to, you know, ask you, because again, you are part of the service. So you know, whenever I get a chance to talk about people in the military and all that, I'm always taking this advantage. You know what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
With that being said, when have you gone to other schools, like, you know, as a recruiter to recruit?
Not at the moment.
But is that something that you would want to be, you'd be down to do?
Eventually down the road.
Down the road.
Sir.
Okay.
Because it seems cool being a recruiter, because my recruiter, yeah, she cool. So it's like,
oh, okay. Yeah. Okay. And did your recruiter, you know, keep it hung with you about them? They're very young, because you know they said some recruiters just tell them like a little small bit.
I feel you. I mean, yeah, she was cool. She was straight up. You know, I mean, I knew it wasn't gonna be easy. So it's like, wow. I mean, that's a given. So yeah, I mean, she kept it 100. You know, she helped me with things, especially with school things and stuff. So she works on PV campus. So it's
I think I know you. I think I know who you're talking about too. Yeah, she's pretty cool too. She's tall, right?
She's taller than me.
Okay. Let's just see. But yeah, she has tattoo. She's actually pretty cool, man. Yeah. So yeah, I knew she was a real one when she started talking like the way she was talking. Yeah. Like, oh yeah, no, she's real.
But
she's real good. So I'm glad that she became your recruiter, though. You know what I'm saying?
She cool.
What are some things that she told you that not just helped you as a soldier but also as a student?
I mean, she told me a lot of things. I'm really not good with memory, so I can't remember a lot of stuff.
That's a bit. From the time, you know, you were born to now, what are some things that have stuck out to you that carry with you to this day? Like, for example, right, I remember when I was in high school, right, there was a quote. It was down the hall. It said, respect, give some, get some. You know? Okay. And that's something that I follow to this day. You know what I'm saying? I respect you, you respect me. You know, respect goes a long way too.
Of course.
It definitely comes a long way. You know what I'm saying? Just be is it something that sticks out to you from your life, from, you know, back then and even to now, that you used to follow?
I feel like family is a big thing. So it's like a family that prays together, stay together. So yeah, just like we said, how family ain't all about blood.
Yeah,
I got homeboys where I call brother.
Yeah,
but they not my real brother or nor blood.
Yeah,
but you know, I still consider them blood brothers.
Yeah,
so I feel like family was a big thing in my life, because we was all diverse. I got a white brother, Asian brother, black brother.
But the color, you know, the race thing does not, you know, what I'm saying, young.
That don't matter.
Yeah. Okay, that's actually one of the things I was going to ask you too. Like, you know what I'm saying, did you ever feel any type of you know, discrimination or any racism, or like feel like, you know,
I mean, kids can be cruel. I ain't gonna cap that. Back
kids,
then
kids yeah,
kids you think I, kids are nice? Hell no. Nah, I mean, when I was in like middle school and all that jazz, I mean, yeah, I get some racist slurs and all that. I mean, I don't pay no attention to it though, because as long as they don't touch me, I'm good.
Oh, facts.
So it's like, yeah, I get discriminated sometimes, but it's life. Like, what can you do about it?
Facts. And what about now, though?
Nah,
okay,
I don't.
That's good. But in your lifetime, you know, in while you were in the service, when you were, you know, in your trend, did you ever feel depression? Did you feel like, you know, like your head, you were not in the right space? And if so, how did you overcome that?
I feel like, okay, with depression, depression is not just suicidal, because I feel like most people think it's a suicidal thing. It's not. It could be a mental thing and all that. But depressed, maybe, probably a few days, because, man, after certain days, I'll be getting tired, and then we got to get right back up in the morning and do that. So, yeah, sometimes I just want to stay in bed, but that's not an option around there.
That's fast. Because, you know, what's it called? I've, you know, felt, you know, I've gone through depression. I know, like you say, it's not a suicide thing too.
Yeah.
And you know, I try not to what's it called, like get in my body. You mean like, you know what I'm saying? Thank God for the gym, bro. You know what I'm saying?
Hey, there you go.
Indeed, thank God for the gym, and thank God for, you know, the music or things keep me so busy. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Because there's sometimes where like, man, I'm like thinking like, man, I'm not sure if I, you know, if I can do this, or you know, feel like, you know. My head, sometimes I'll have months where my headspace is not, you know, where it needs to be. But I'm like, man, I have responsibilities. I have a podcast to do. I have a degree that I'm trying to achieve. I have this, I have that going on. So I have no time to be depressed. I have to get this shit done. Respectfully. Respectfully. So, okay. So I just wanted to ask you, because some soldiers do have dealt with that before. So I don't know if you were, you know, one of them. I know that.
So, yeah, therapy is a big thing.
And they have that too. And that's is that in the Sharp, or that's in EC?
I think that's an EO.
EO, my bad. Okay, EO.
Yeah, EO stands for Equal Opportunity.
Okay.
I think that's an EO, but therapy is a big thing. Therapy is not just about talking to others. Therapy could be the gym, music, all that. So it's like, therapy is a big thing.
Okay. If you could go back, you know, in your first journey in the military in camp, what made you guys, if you could remember, what made you guys finally become a team? Because I know it will take a little bit of a while before you all finally become a team. I know that. So what were some things that made y'all finally become a team?
I feel like when we work together, like when we're forced to work together, and then we achieve that goal that we want, then we all get happy because we all achieve that same goal. So I feel like at that point in time, I feel like that's the time where, yeah, then we could become something bigger than one.
And how long did it take? Like,
I feel like it took, I'd be 3 weeks for real.
Oh, 3 weeks? Oh,
yeah. Because there's phases and stuff. Yeah. It's like red, white, and blue. And then blue is the last phase, white is the middle, and then red is the beginning.
Okay, I see. And is it true that you know every person is different? You know, so you might learn something quicker than I am.
Yeah.
So in camp, did they have like a I don't say a room, but like, you know, if you are hard headed, they put like a tape on you, saying like a color on you, like, oh, you know, you're hard, you don't really like to listen and all that. Oh, that's just
I mean, we didn't do that.
Okay.
Because it's a difference between basic training and basic camp. Mm. I think the people here, they go to basic camp, but I went to basic training. Because basic camp is shorter than basic training.
Okay.
So, yeah, it's a difference, because I went over to Missouri for basic training.
Okay.
So, yeah. That tape thing, I don't think I heard of that.
Oh, okay. Yeah, you could be right. No, yes, it could be done. It's maybe not being in that.
Yeah, okay.
For those that, you know, that are looking into join the military, what are some key advice that you could give out to them?
I feel like just be mentally strong, because it is gonna put a toll on you, and also be prepared. Like, don't try to miss things so much. Because
when you say miss things, what do you mean?
I mean like by because they gonna take your phone and all that away, so you won't be able to call your parents, your significant other, all that. So be prepared for that, because that was a big thing. Because after everybody got, because I think you get your phone back after like 2 weeks, and only for like an hour on the weekend. So it's like, after everybody just got done calling their significant other or their people, everybody just started breaking down, because they miss them so much. So I feel like, be prepared to feel that kind of way, and also have a strong mental health, because it does a lot.
Okay. And what else could you get to the people?
But like, shit, you got gotta try to stay in shape because they will run you to death.
You know, what if you're already in shape though? But like, you know, there's a difference between in shape and being in military shape. Yeah. Or are they the same?
I feel like it depends. I feel like because military, they gonna make you work out every day.
Because I ain't gonna hold you. I thought I was in shape, boy. But once we did actually PT, when we did PT, I'm like, damn.
Yeah.
I'm actually not in shape.
Nah, it be like that. Hey, I be feeling like that sometimes. Man.
Especially when we have to wake up at 5 a.m. I don't know, y'all. Did you have to wake up at 5 a.m.?
Yeah. But so sometimes for this PT at PV.
Yeah.
So sometimes I get off of work at 5. So I just go straight into PT.
Oh.
Yes. Because I work overnight. I work at 10.
Overnight. Okay.
Yeah. Sometimes I just get off of work, go get my clothes, put them on, come to PT.
Go to PT. Okay. Yeah, that 5 a.m. It'd be fine. I'm not gonna hold it up. I mean,
it's made for some people. It's not made for others.
Yeah. The only thing I hated, but over time started to like it, was the running.
Okay. Yeah.
Because you know, I could run. I know that I had not good quads, but then after a while, you know, once we started to, you know, just run with no stops, yeah. It's like, damn.
After a while, your body gonna get used to
it.
You do it consistently.
Yeah, especially that's another thing too. I realized that I wasn't doing the work, the exercise consistently. That's why I wasn't in the shape I was in. But over time, I started to like it, and then I could keep up with other people as well.
Yeah.
So what was your favorite workout weight, both in the military and in PT?
I feel like,
exercise. It's more like exercise, really.
I feel like I don't even got a favorite because every time they make me do workout, it's torture. It's like, oh, you think you finna do 10 push-ups? No, we finna do 100. I'm like, damn. And then, I feel like the hardest exercise for me, because I don't got a favorite, man.
Wow.
Fuck them exercise. I feel like the hardest one's probably the push-up because.
Oh, damn.
Because.
Well, which version of the push-up, though?
Okay, there's a hand release and then there's regular.
You're talking about the what's it called? When you go down and then you have to spread your arms. That's hand release. Oh, I hated that one, bro.
After a while, that's gonna get you. Cause during our
it looked easy too, though. I told you, like, I could go back and do that. Yeah. But then when you do a few of those, oh yeah.
Cause during the test, you gotta do as many as those
for the AFCT, right?
You gotta do that as many as you can in 2 minutes.
Yeah. Well, do you remember your highest?
My highest is probably like 46, something like that.
I thought you beat me.
I think to get 100 is like
I'm good. As long as it's more than 20, I'm good. Cause I did it. And the highest I did, cause we did both.
Yeah.
I did the highest one was 35.
Okay.
So when I heard 35, I was like, for real? Hey, yo, let's go. I'll take it. Because I thought I did less than that. But you're talking about you. Because I thought the push-up was just going to be like, you know,
yeah. Because we do push-ups in cadence. So it's like every one count is 2 push-ups. So if you do cadence in 50, you actually did 100 push-ups. Okay, so it's like, and they just keep going. Yeah. They don't stop.
I know what's so funny? Going back on the ASCT. There's a workout. There's a thing you have to do. It's called the I forgot what's called. Oh, pool. Yeah, pool. Oh, yeah. Dragon carry.
Yep.
But okay. I'm talking about the pool part where I think there's a plate that you have to pull.
Yeah.
Back and forth.
Yeah.
When I did that, bro. When I saw people doing it, I'm like, that shit is lying in the book, bro. Like, bro, why are you struggling about it, bro?
Okay.
But then when I actually did it, I'm like, wait, hold on.
Oh my gosh. The spin jack carry.
It looked deceiving, bro.
You think it's light? Nah.
Bro.
After you're done and then you got to run? Oh, yeah. Oh, your legs God. Are dead.
Bro, my calves was like about to pull out. My legs were like, GG.
Hell no. Nah.
But the thing was so, it's light, though.
It looks light.
I'm okay. It
looks like, can be deceiving.
I definitely got deceived, bro.
Yeah.
And then they were talking about running. I'm like, look at you. Who running? Like, who running? Not me. But you know, because I did it and all that, you know what I'm saying? But I was just like, damn. I had the whole thing. That was the only thing that caught me. Because, you know, the throw was, you know, that's probably the easiest one. I'm not going to hold you. And then, you know, the spring was, you know, the spring was, I hate it because, you know, because once you're done with the pull, you had to spring.
Mm-hmm.
And I ain't going to hold you. I could not run. Man,
I know how that feels. Yeah. I've been there.
Yeah. Then they took my run. I was like, damn. Because that's the last part. Yeah. But luckily for me, you know, I got long legs. So yeah. I'll just take one step. One huge step and just go, yo, bro. As long as I beat it, I don't care. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, yeah, that was a cool experience. And, you know, being part of a team, you know what I'm saying? I think that's one of the few things that people like about the military, that you're part of a team. That, you know, you're not looked at as, you know, oh, I'm black and you're black, we can relate. No, it's a battle buddy. You know, you're part of a family. You're all trying to do better and be better.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? And the instructors were pretty cool too. You know, I had Sergeant Bomber.
Okay. Yeah. This was last year.
Yeah, I know, which is kind of sucks because, like, damn, then the next people after us, bro, they're not going to have another teacher like, you know, like him like that. But he was a cool teacher, man. Yeah. And he kept it real. Mm-hmm. That's something I had to give him props for. You know, he kept it real with me and to us as well. And he was sharp to PT. I don't know because he had to, but I don't think he had to, but the fact that he did, you know what I'm saying? Like, I had to give him more respect because, you know, he could have done. He don't got nothing to prove nothing to us. Mm-hmm. Like, what?
He already made it.
Yeah, for real. So the fact that he joined us almost every day at 5 a.m. with PT, work out with us too. And Colonel too. Yeah. He's just like, man, make me more like, bro, I have no excuse not to show up at PT.
I'm trying to get up to his rank, Colonel,
boy, he's cool too. You know what I'm saying? But I just feel like Sergeant Bum is just cool. I mean, he's like, he's that one friend, like, you know what I'm saying, that you would want to have at your wedding, because, you know, he will say some crazy stuff, but he end up with keeping something 100. You know what I'm saying, man. Hey, shout out to you, Mr. Bomber, man. I don't know if you go watch it, but if you do, man, thank you.
Yes, sir.
Besides that, you know, the ACAT, man. Can you tell me when the process of you being contracted, how you felt, and did you have your family with you at that time, and how did you know you were getting contracted?
So, I don't think I'm getting. Well, I'm contracted with Big Army.
Yeah.
So I don't think I'm getting contracted with ROTC.
Well, let's start with the Big Army.
Big Army. So I feel like it was cool. I feel like, you know, it was an achievement. It was a big achievement.
But how did you know that? Did they call you? Did you get a letter?
After you graduate, they let you know.
Oh, they let you. Oh, okay. Yeah, okay,
so
okay.
It's like, man, this is a big thing. So, yeah, it was cool, though. It was a cool experience.
You cried a little bit, though.
You felt a little bit of emotion.
I
was happy. I was happy.
You went, okay. I was okay, happy. Okay. That's a bit. And did you have your family with you at that time?
Yeah, not? During my graduation, my mama couldn't come because she had work and stuff.
Oh, okay.
But I went with some of my battle buddies, people, so it was cool.
And please tell me you took a picture with that too, bro.
Hmm?
Did you take a picture of you, like, saying the thing?
Oh, no, we ain't take. I mean, I took pictures in my uniform and stuff.
Yeah. Oh, okay. That's a bit. With that being said, are you looking to, you know, maybe join another branch? I mean, what's your time in the army? Is, you know, at least.
I feel like I'm just being in the army for 20 years. Retire after that.
Yeah. Okay. Because, you know, some people, you know, go from one place to another. So I thought, you know.
Nah, I think I'm just going for 20. Yeah. My time.
If you could tell, you know, the younger people, you know, young generation that are in high school that think about joining the military or the army, what are some key factors that you should keep in mind?
I feel like just be open minded. You know, be open to everything. Like, and you gotta have a big heart, cause army ain't no joke. But
when you say big heart, what do you mean by big heart?
I mean, like, treating others.
Okay.
In that instance, but like, I feel like it's gonna give you a whole bunch of experience though. So it's like, it's a good experience, but it's not made for everybody. Mm. So it's like, just make sure you have the right mindset and be mentally prepared for this.
If you when it's all said and done, right? You know, you did your army thing, you know what I'm saying, for 25 years. and you know, you graduate year and all that, what do you want as your legacy?
Like,
or what do you want people to remember about you?
Man, I don't feel safe. Yeah, man, that was Cook. He did his thing. You know, he was a cool guy. You know, kind hearted and all that. So I feel like, of course, I'm be crazy too. I'm a crazy dude.
Man, we all got but, crazy nuts, bro. Yeah. You ain't the only one. You ain't the only one, my boy.
Yeah.
But yeah.
But yeah, I want to leave a good legacy though. I want a good appearance on my name because that's also my mama name. So.
Okay. Okay. Yeah. Okay. And in some ways, do you consider yourself a role model to some, you know, some people, some students? You know,
I feel like I'm a role model to my little brother.
Okay.
Yeah, he always like doing he always like doing what I do. So it's like, yeah, he trying to follow my footsteps, but at the end of the day, he got his own story, so he got to tell that his own.
But okay, but you know, you knowing that your little brother looks up to you, has that shifted the way you do certain things and carry yourself?
Of course, yes, because I don't want him seeing me do wrong and then he end up doing wrong. So it's like, that's gonna make me feel some type of way. That's gonna put the. I feel like I'm gonna take the blame for that because I showed him that, and then he thinks it's right, which is wrong. Mm. So yeah, certain things I do.
Okay, well, man, you know, when it's all said and done, my boy, you know, when you become a coach, going back to the school and all that, man, if you could just do me one favor, bro, when you find, you know, whichever team you're on, right, and as a coach, try to carry the characteristics of discipline and respect and carry that bond with your players, man.
Of course.
You know what I'm saying? Don't get me wrong, you know, the sport itself, wrestling, is a fun sport. It's also more, it's been more impactful if you talk to them more about outside of sport, because you know, you can only play that sport to a certain degree.
Yes,
you know what I'm saying? So I think it's very important that you know, you carry the knowledge that you've got from PV, from the military, and your life as well, because you know, you might know what's it called, your story might even impact a student.
Yes, sir.
You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so that's my advice to you, man. If you
appreciate you. Yeah, I agree 100%.
Fair, man. But man, appreciate you for once again for coming to this episode, Next Gen Podcast, man. If you have anything to say to the people, man, go ahead.
Hey, man, just live life, you know. Good morning. Shit.
Alright, that's a red. And you heard it from yourself, man. You know what I'm saying? Where can they find you at, man?
Y'all can find me on Instagram, Cookie by Profession.
I'll
be on there most of the time.
Alright, that's a bet. I'm putting on IG and
sure.
all that, man.
Appreciate you.
No, the pleasure is mine, man. You know what I'm saying? That's the least I could do.
Yes, sir.
And with that being said, man, it's about this episode. We're going home. I got one shot. You lose the love and respect. That's where the trust stop. New work, top drop. I roll up every 15 minutes like a bus stop. And you can smell this how I'm smoking when I burn out. And you can catch me riding dirty, but my car not. It's love and loyalty into my heart lot. Never turn your back, won't know how I turn out. I said it once, I do it again. I'm playing the game, I do it to win. With you and your friend, that's taking thin. It's me and my team, you know we gon' win. You know we gon' ball, you know we gon' rise to the wheels fall off. You know we gon' stick to the goal, we ain't thinking about y'all. I feel like the sky is falling down. Ain't nobody